But let's get back to the position of an athletic director. Right. What experience is required of such a person? You have to be a gym coach, a coach of a team
No,
first?
Not necessarily.
You have to be an administrator? What does it require?
No, not necessarily.
All of the above?
I think you should have a love and a connection with sports. You should know a lot about how to deal with people, how to deal with budgets. You should have an education that should bring you towards administration and supervision, and on some level. It doesn't necessarily have to be in physical education. It doesn't necessarily have to be in athletics. But you should be able to deal with people. You should be able to have an open door. You should be able to deal with coaches and deal with student athletes, and you should have empathy.
And of all those things you just described, what do you find most gratifying personally to you? Which is the one that really makes you tick?
Well, it's when you see a team succeed, when you see a team win, when you see the expressions on the players' faces, on the coaches' faces, when they win a game. It is so exhilarating. It is so fundamentally sound that people are achieving success. And even if a team is not successful in conference or overall, but when they win, it's just tremendous. Miguel.
So tell me about some of those very proud moments when you felt like, my God, this is it. Can you recall a few of those moments when you felt like, Jesus, this is what I was born to do?
Right. Naturally, when a team succeeds, when a team wins a championship, the culmination of the season, where you have goals, you have aims, you have objectives, and at the end of that season, let's use women's basketball for example. You play 27 games, and now you win a championship, and now that goal is realized. It's just a tremendous feeling, not only for myself, but a tremendous feeling for the coaches and for the student athletes.
So tell me about the economy, because the economy has hurt everybody in the country. Yeah. Is it hurting sports, and is it hurting athletic programs like yours in any way?
It depends on how your programs are funded. It depends on who you have to depend on for the almighty dollar. And I think Lehman has got a great model. I think we work hard at funding programs with student activity money. I work extremely hard in funding programs with money that we bring in from the Apex. And
are there also sponsors? Do you go out and get sponsors for the Apex, or a sponsor, like say a major corporation that can serve as a sponsor of a team or part of the Apex?
We try. It's very difficult to go out and get major sponsors for a Division III program, but the on-campus beverage, Pepsi-Cola, they're very good at giving us product, so that the kids could have product for their teams and for their practices. We also get some other minor promotional items from them. But in order to go out and get a major donor, a major corporate sponsor at this level, it's sometimes very difficult.
One of the things I've wanted to talk to you about off the air, but I'm going to do it on the air, is that you are the athletic director. We are in the journalism program. We should be working together somehow. We have this new facility here, the Multimedia Center at Lehman College. And I think that some of your activities, some of your games, we should cover. And we should cover by way of podcasts, mm-hmm. putting them on the internet. Our students, my journalism students, should be covering your games.
Yep.
We need that interaction that has been lacking, I think. But my God, I mean, if I want to train students to be sports reporters, what
right.
better place than to send
right.
them to you
right.
to cover your teams? And what better place for you to come to than to us, for us to broadcast your events and your activities? So I hope this is the beginning of a wonderful relationship here. I'm very serious about it.
Well, I think it would be a great marriage, Miguel. I say that the state-of-the-art athletic facility is the Apex, but after seeing what you have here,
the Multimedia
this
Center
is certainly the flagship of CUNY. And we have over the internet, we're able to stream our games live. We'd love to do something with your students who are interested in getting broadcast experience and getting writing experience, helping us out with our website. I I'm your biggest fan.
Thank you. And you also have a public relations person who's also a coach, right?
Well, we have a sports information director. His name is Andrew Pearson. He's with us full time. He does our website. He covers our games.
And he writes all the press releases, which I see announcing all your activities.
And he writes all the press releases. He takes care of all that business. Mm-hmm.
So maybe that's the person that we should get together with my journalism students so that we could start something going real soon.
Great.
Listen, let me tell you that we are extremely proud of what we see in the rest of Lehman. I don't know if you're aware of this, but the rest of Lehman College is extremely proud every time, number one, we hear about how your teams are doing, and number two, every time we walk through that Apex Center, because it's first of all, it's spotless. It's very well maintained, mm-hmm. and it's really, you said it, it's the flagship of Lehman College. Mm-hmm. And I feel that what I see in the students that are coming out of the Apex who are involved in your programs, mm-hmm. is this sense of pride of your athletes, this sense of self-awareness of who they are. And I don't know who is teaching them that, but whoever it is, please congratulate them on my part, because you are instilling a sense of the students of confidence that they need here at Lehman and all over. And what is making that happen? I mean, is that is that part of the approach of your educational approach? Is that what your coaches are trying to instill? How does that come about?
Well, it's multifaceted, Miguel. I mean, I am very, very big on excellence. We hire the best coaches. We supervise those coaches. We make sure they know what my goals and objectives are. We make sure that they know that Lehman College has to be their number one place. And they have to instill that in their student athletes. Not only do we want kids to perform on the court, in the pool, on the field, but we want kids to perform in the classroom. And I stress all the time that we are in a very visible business. We are out there representing Lehman College. We are complementing whatever programs Lehman College has. And it's very important for the coaches and our student athletes on our teams to succeed, not always win, but succeed. And I think that attitude comes from the top. It goes down. I'm in constant contact with my coaches. I go to most of the home games, if not all of them. And if I see something that I think we can do better, believe me, I go and I make my feelings known.
All right, we're almost out of time, but how do we get a hold of you, your facility? First of all, tell me the website again.
LehmanAthletics.com. 960-1117 is our phone number.
And on the website, will they find, let's say that they just want to use the facilities, they want to register as a member of the facility, mm-hmm. do they find on the website information about that?
You will find a link on our website on the left-hand side menu bar, and it'll have the Apex logo. Go right to the Apex logo, and there you are.
And it'll give you the rates and everything?
And it will give you the rates, it will give you the hours, it will give you our programs, it will give you everything we have to offer.
Okay, and the number again for more information?
718-960-1117.
Dr. Soren, it's a pleasure having you on the program.